remember, AI is just mathematics. So a lot of people are worried about a conflict between AI and humans. And I would like to help lay to rest any worries about conflicts between AI and humans, because you cannot be in conflict with a mathematical equation. It's not going to bite you. It cannot harm you by itself. It's a mathematical equation. We have a beautiful equation, my favorite one, for gradient descent, which is what we use to train the neural networks. That's how a neural network learns what it is that it needs to learn. It improves gradually. It has knowledge which is encapsulated in these W's, and the W's keep getting updated according to the gradient of what we call our cost function, the thing that we are trying to optimize. And we start with a neural network which has nodes, little circles, as you can see here on the left, and connections between these. We have dense, fully connected neural networks where all of the nodes of the network are connected to each other, which result in what we call dense matrix calculations. So we have dense matrices that we have to multiply in order to do the calculations. And then you have more modern sparse interactions where we say, let's have less interconnects. And then we can use sparse matrix calculations. That has fundamental impact on the hardware that we're using to compute. So sparse matrix versus dense matrix computations, very different. With dense matrices, you have a lot of computation that you have to deal with. With sparse matrices, you have a lot of communication. You have to send a lot of data back and forth. The actual number of arithmetic operations is reduced. And so the hardware that we need to build is very different here. So let's look a little bit into what that means for our real world. We have the computing industry trying to learn how to train neural networks and how to execute them. And on the left, the obvious winners over many years now have been GPUs, of course. But one interesting example that I like to mirror mathematics over to the real world is when Intel bought Nervana many years ago now. Nervana built a chip for dense matrices, for fully connected networks. And almost as soon as Intel bought Nervana, very soon thereafter, they realized actually what you need to compute in modern AI are sparse matrices, are sparse neural networks. And so the shape of the networks that people prefer has changed. And Intel had to go from a few hundred million acquisition of Nervana to over a billion, maybe even 2 billion. Acquisition of Habana. And so real world implications, real conflict between math, should we use this math versus that math, which has actual consequences in the real world of which companies succeed, which companies fail, which technologies succeed, which technologies fail. Watch out here. And how we build hardware and software to live in that world. Now, on CPUs, of course, people say, well, you can do anything you want. You don't need any special hardware. You just use layers of abstraction to make it easy to do. So we want to have as many people as possible use AI. And so there's a drive to make AI as easy as possible. Every time you make something easier to program, you make the computer easier to use, you're also making it a lot slower. So there are two forces in conflict in computing for AI. One is make it easier and accessible to everyone. And the other one is make it go faster, because we don't want to wait for days at a time on getting results back from artificial intelligence. We like real time, we like interactive activity. And that conflict reminds me of economics, where you have the risk-reward principle. The more risk you take, the more reward you get. And almost every single person who's interested in commercial activity tells me they're not interested in taking more risk, but they would like to increase their potential reward. So even though the fundamental law says that there is a risk-reward principle, the more risk you take, the more reward you should expect, nobody wants this to be true, and nobody will accept it in any commercial discussion. Same thing happens here in AI. If you try to engage people with the concept that if you make something easier to use, it's going to run slower. Make it 10 times easier to use, it's going to run 10 times slower. People don't want to hear that. It is a completely unwelcome and unattractive proposition. They say, make it easy to use so anybody can do it. At the same time, we want it to run as fast as possible. So we want both. No risk and full reward. Easy to program and absolute maximum speed. So that creates a natural conflict within which you have many, many startups trying to benefit from that discrepancy in expectations and what can be done.